Tom is coming and scoring goals today.
Good morning and welcome to Reading, the Madejski Stadium, and it's day two of the PlayStation Schools Cup Festival. Wonderful stadium here in Reading, and we've seen five matches already, five superb matches yesterday, some real crackers in there, and here we are getting ready for day two of the action. This is the first match, is the U12 Elite Schools Cup. And it's the only trophy that Wright Robinson seem to have not won this season. Yes, they did the double yesterday in the AMBs. They lost to Northampton in the semi-final. So, in a very tight match. And, yesterday, Wright Robinson looked pretty unbeatable. Won 7-0 in their final. So, you've got to say, looking at this match, Northampton School for Boys must have a pretty decent team if they beat Wright Robinson yesterday.
Yeah.
With me, John Scales. Former Liverpool, Bristol Rovers. I've said them in a different order every time. Tottenham, Wimbledon. Played for England as well, which is no mean feat in the golden years as well, when there were some real top players out there. And, anything that's not, don't know about football is not worth knowing as far as John's concerned. He's guided me through a number of years here in the commentary seat. And we have got, two big footballing schools. Whitgift, actually, a big rugby school. We see Whitgift at Twickenham quite a few times in the Schools Cup final on rugby union, but we have seen them here, and last year or the year before we saw them here, and they actually closed the whole school down for the day because it was such an occasion that their football team had qualified. I don't think they are going to make the same effort this morning because they've got the opposite of the Graveshaft shift. They've got the 9:30 match, which means having to play with the M25 in the morning, which is not good from Croydon at all. And I've got a feeling that possibly the whole school may be in some assembly hall or classrooms watching this match now. So hello everybody over at Whitgift, and please send us a little tweet using the hashtag Schools Cup Selfie, and we'll be able to see that picture. So do send us a picture at Whitgift and of course at Northampton. If you're watching this in a central place, I understand there's exams and there's lots of things going on at school, so it's difficult for you to travel at this time of year and support your team. But taking a couple of hours out to watch them on the big screen is not such a big deal, I gather, and a lot of schools are doing that. The teams are due to come out. They're a little bit late. Usually they're early and they catch me and John out, and I'm out of breath as I'm running about the place. John's still quite as fit as a fiddle. And here we are, we're actually waiting now, so there you go, we've done our opening. And John, just what a day it was yesterday. How enjoyable was yesterday?
Great day, fantastic day of football. Didn't expect to see any rain, but we had a little bit of rain late morning, which was great for the surface. I've heard they might put the sprinklers on today. I think it's a good idea at some point, maybe half time or at some point during the day, they just keep the pitch a little bit of a surface that the ball zips around as the teams come out. It's a beautiful morning, and if anything's to go by yesterday, I'm sure we're in for another absolutely cracking day. And what a way to start it off with these two teams.
Yes, two heavyweight football sides here going out. And Northampton School for Boys, well, they're no strangers to ESFA finals. But it's nice to see Whitgift have made it at the under 12 level as well. So this is the first year of real serious competition for these boys. And, you know, this is going to be the biggest occasion of their lives. Look at them. Some of them are little dots out there. But one of the things we discovered yesterday with the under 12 competition is there's some real good football brains out there. As the two teams shake hands, and great pictures here from Jack on our camera down pitch side. It's always lovely to get the interviews with the coaches, and teams are obviously, there's going to be a few butterflies in there, but I was hugely impressed with the quality of play we saw yesterday all the way through. And you know, with the girls football in particular also, it was superb to see. Yep. Let's have a quick look at the teams. Whitgift School, Alfie Lam in goal, Sergio Roccia, number two, Santo Boniface, number three, four is Andre Gray, five, Jake Grant, or Grante, maybe. I'm going to have to choose one way or the other. I'll go with Grant, and apologies if I do get it wrong. Atto Ampor is six, Asha Agbinoni is seven, Brooke Myers eight, and Conrad Norman is nine. It's nine-a-side football. Andrew Martin is the manager. Nine-a-side football and rolling substitutes. Northampton School for Boys, Owen Hay is one, Ruben Hansen two, Levin Stewart three, Will Barrett four, Will Cowley is five, Carl Kelly six, Isaac Black seven, Harley Mills is eight, and Logan Briggs is nine. Josh Melling is the manager for Northampton School for Boys. Substitutes bench, Noah Antinardis is Ben Lyons, Connor Budd, Pascal Rocha, and George McCray. I think there's a slight typo there, but I think that's probably, I'm just having a little look at there. In fact, I'm not sure who that is. So I don't have, oh, there you are, George Mace. Okay, so somebody just put a capital E in there on the end. Bad boy. And then Northampton School Boys, Adam Alexander, Ollie Dale, Joshua McWilliams-West, that's a good old name, and Ted Dolby and Cyrus Bruce is are our substitutes for Northampton. So this will be... This is a 30 minutes match, 30 minutes each way. George Kimber Sweatman is... official, and I'm Adrian Battersby here, and John Scales beside me, and John has been involved with this level of football for many, many years, and having given up a pro game. When was your last game, John? What year did you play
until? I don't say. Don't ask that
before
question.
These kids
first
were born,
morning,
that's for sure.
Yeah. Before this lot were born, yeah. Back it was in the... After the millennium, let's put it that way. So I've made it into the millennium.
Sorry, I've
just
got off to a bad start with you already.
In there.
Yeah, you just got there. Just got 2000, did you?
Yeah.
Well done.
2001, I think I retired. But no, I've been watching the two teams warming up. And you just know the professionalism of these two sides. The quality that we're going to see in this game was evident in the warm-up. The drills that they were doing. I mean, look, I know Steve Kember from Whitgift. I've seen Whitgift in these tournaments a lot. I've been down to Whitgift, and what phenomenal facilities. And like you were talking about, you know, they've got a rugby pedigree.
Heritage, yeah.
All sorts of sports. I mean, the facilities are incredible. Yeah. And Steve Kember, ex-Chelsea, ex-Crystal Palace, synonymous with Crystal Palace Football Club. I think he's the chief scout. So long, illustrious connection with both Chelsea and Crystal Palace. And Colin Pates will be here with Whitgift again as the coach, another ex-Chelsea player.
And interesting looking at the alumni from the school. You know, we've got Chelsea, we've got Nathan Baxter, Chelsea, Josh Grant, Chelsea, Luke Dreher,
well,
Crystal Palace,
go.
Victor
yeah.
Moses yeah. went to Whitgift. Yeah. He's at Chelsea now. Andre Coker, Crystal Palace. You know, they've all stayed in the area.
You can see they've really got that connection with both those clubs, and that's probably because of Colin and Steve. But most of all, because of the work they do with developing young talent, and just watching the warm-up was phenomenal at this age group to be so disciplined and have such technical ability in the drills that they were doing, both Northampton and Whitgift. So I'm really excited about this game.
So Whitgift School in the white and navy, And Northampton School for Boys in the red and white. Northampton are going to get us underway here. And it is great to see how the coaches put in a big effort with the boys and girls at under 12 level. And as you say, they really want to start off in good habits, because they're going to have these kids all the way through to the older age groups. And yeah, of course, one of the lovely things is that the coaches will start at the under-12s and will stay with them throughout,
yeah,
all the way up to the older age group. It's a lovely way that the schools manage it. So we just had a delay there as the linesman needed to do something. I don't know what it was, but we are off. And the final here of the Under 12 Elite Schools Cup. Well, absolutely thrilling day yesterday, and always wonderful to see. Don't want to hop on too much about it, because there's a lovely turn around the outside here. Here's an opportunity into the side net, but danger bell's ringing already, as there was a simple one-on-one and used a bit of pace there from the centre forward, number 9. Logan Briggs, look how he just turned his defender there, yeah, and pace as well.
Yeah, lovely. Sergio Roche just getting a bit tight to him. I think Briggs has got to pull that back, cut it back across the face of the goal. And I think it may have been Ruben Hansen, the number 2 coming in for Northampton.
Yeah.
Who could have had a chance of, had that been pulled back by Briggs. But it's a wake-up call for Whitgift, if one was needed in the opening seconds of this game. Lovely, yeah, turn.
I was just going to say about, you know, one of the things I really noticed, sort of, you know, having my little evening Ovaltine last night and just thinking through the day's matches, and just how wonderful it was to see the girls really step up. And here's a chance again. Briggs going to show his pace, but goalkeeper covers this one. And you know, it was a wonderful thing to see how the girls, the quality of the girls was so good, but also the quality of the young girls.
Yeah.
Almost the under 13 girls was almost as good as the under 15 match in terms of quality. And you think, well, these are the girls coming up. They're only, yep, going to get better. It's almost like they've reached a higher level at a younger age. And you can almost saw it physically there in the two finals, that the under 13 and under 15 wasn't a great deal of difference, no, in terms of quality.
No, and I think that's what I was sort of alluding to in the commentary yesterday, the rapid acceleration of girls' football. You know, the younger girls have been playing for as long as the sort of under 15s, you feel, and they're developing those skills very early, and it's fantastic to see the game, the girls so far advanced now. That was Brooke Myers just going through on goal there from Whitgift. Good chance, backed off, just Will Cowley, the centre half for Northampton, allowed that shot, nothing came of it. He's on the ball again, Myers in the middle of midfield. There's going to be a battle in there.
Yeah,
back up there with Logan Briggs. Great skill again.
Briggs really does. He's already had a couple of opportunities. We're only 2 minutes into this, and he's already looking like somebody that Northampton School are going to try and get the ball to.
Yeah, they're really going to try and feed the ball into him. He's that pivotal figure. Good ball, lovely give and go. Pull back again, and Conrad Norman feeding that ball out wide to Agbinona. Getting the ball cut back again, Northampton dealing with it, but Whitgift on the attack again. Yeah, that's a very bright start to the game.
Absolutely, very open start, isn't it? They see that both attacking units have got a bit of something about them there. Let's have a quick look at this run again on the replay.
Paul just giving away here. That's the little give and go. Lovely little move. And there, it's just
Agbinoni
just cutting the ball back, and then a little shimmy, and they're away, Northampton. But nice move from Whitgift. I mean, very interesting to see Sergio Roccia, quite small, up against Logan Briggs, the number 9 for Northampton.
Yeah. Yeah.
Quite isolated, it's sort of a 1v1. Just got to be careful. I think they've got to have the two wide players, Whitgift, just dropping a bit deeper in.
Yeah.
Allow the fullbacks to give Roccia a little bit more support. He is really being left one-on-one, and
yeah,
and that's my only concern looking at the Whitgift back line, is that they if the Northampton midfield run on, they're overwhelmed Whitgift a little bit.
It's an unusual formation, because normally in most matches you always see an extra man at the back. And in this situation, just looking, it seems that every player is marking every man. And yeah. It's one-on-one all the way through. Well, and up front, there's one-on-one.
Yeah, they're going to... traditionally, you're going to get one striker because you've got three defenders. So one attacker, and then it's really the midfield, whether you've got three that are going to push up and support, and you get those sort of four attacking players when you're in possession and sweeping forward. And that's the key. The key is always the sort of numbers. Hurts, he's won the tackle, and Northampton come around and sweep up and avert the danger.
Yes, Brooke Myers was looking to get in on the action there. And Whitgift looking dangerous themselves. Both teams looking dangerous in the other half. And
yeah.
That time there was a little bit of support for Rocha. It is. They are playing a three at the back, Whitgift, and it's a 3-3-2 system they're going for. Here's Agbenoni, and he has a go with the left foot straight into the keeper.
Yeah, it was good work from Agbenoni, cutting in well, probably onto his weaker foot. But good effort to test the keeper, Owen Haig.
Andre Gray as well there, and Brooke Myers goes out wide. Agbenoni falls over, but it's a foul and a free kick.
Well, I feel Andre Gray is going to have a very big role in this game. The number four for Whitgift, just holding in the midfield area.
Jack Grant, the captain, will take this free kick. Whitgift have four in the box, with Brooke Myers just on the edge looking for the ball coming out. So pushed a few in here. Got a little bit of height in there, but well cleared by Northampton. And Boniface just puts the ball out. Going to be an early substitution. Number 11, Cyrus Bunce for Northampton's coming on. And it is rolling substitutions. One of the Northampton players just taking a little early break.
Yeah, well, I think
only
he's
six
just holding his
in.
Knee a bit, isn't he?
Grant cuts that out, but Briggs picks it up. Myers picks it up. Briggs out wide, long distance shot. Both goalkeepers look very solid indeed. No problems at all holding on to those. Here's Ampau. Ampau goes out to Grant. Nice to see both teams, you know, playing really good football. Goalkeeper's a little bit in no man's land there, but this defender helps him out and gives a corner. Just lovely to see that you know, we're playing proper football out there. You know, again, he's under 12 level, and you know that each ball being played over a distance is played with a purpose. It's not just a big ball forward or anything like that.
No, and you can see in the middle of the box there, Conrad Norman showing his pace, number 9 for Whitgift, down in that channel. Nice ball. First time we've really seen him open his legs up.
Grant wins the header at the far post and pulled it back. There's a little bit of height in there for Whitgift.
Yeah, I did think in the warm-up that Whitgift looks sort of bigger, more dominant, but actually out on the pitch there, I think they're pretty evenly matched, these two teams.
Yeah.
You know, we saw at times yesterday just one or two players' physicality was so much bigger and greater. There's a chance. Oh, it hits the stanchion, I think.
It's Atto Ampau there.
Ampau again.
Was through on goal, and yes, did it hit the post, or was it just the stanchion behind? We'll see in a second.
No, I think it's the stanchion, isn't it?
Let's have a little look. It's
lovely little give and go, and a lovely ball there into the space. Great ball.
Yeah, off,
hits
off
the
post,
doesn't it? Up at
top of the post.
Corner. Lovely move. We saw the quick interchanges just a few minutes ago. We had that replay. There again, lovely one-touch football.
First major chance of Whitgift. Cleared by Hansen.
Of course, this is the Elite Schools Cup. There's no restriction on academy boys. I haven't got a list of where these boys are playing their football exactly, but
yeah,
I think safe to say many of them will be at professional clubs.
Yeah. Oh, here's Briggs. Grant's also fast. And Grant manages to clear up nicely there. Both go down a little bit heavier. Now, I'll just have a quick look at again at this big chance from behind.
It's that ball there. It's what a ball. Perfect weighted ball. Allows Ampau to just come onto the ball, not to break stride, have a clean strike. Dream for any player when you get the sort of ball played into space perfectly weighted like that.
Nice control from Bruce. Whitgift pick it up. Whitgift starting to just put a little bit of dominance into this first half. It's a lovely ball in. Here's Great. And saved by the goalkeeper.
Yeah, straight at him. Could have gone anywhere, either side of him. It would probably have beaten the keeper. As it was straight at him. As I say, Andre Gray doing really well to get back into that midfield. They've made a little change at the back, Whitgift. Grant's gone into the middle of the back four at the three.
Here's an opportunity. Both teams, when they attack, this game has got goals all over it. And here comes Whitgift. This is a great move forward from Agbenoni. Goes out wide. Ampau. Three in the box for Whitgift.
Good feet.
Just doesn't find one of his own men. Back to Gray. Great play here from Whitgift. We're really seeing some good football now. Boniface.
Doesn't find Grant's in there.
And here's Biggs.
Roger, who was in the middle of the three. And there he is. Roger just picks the ball up. He's moved out to the right of those three at the back. Grant into the middle to deal with the pace of Logan Briggs. Tactical switch by the bench.
And interesting. That just shows that the bench has noticed and they wanted to put. And Grant's obviously got a lot of pace. He's the captain for Whitgift. And they've decided that he can deal with Briggs. Well, pace-wise, we'll just look at a replay here of that move. Lovely little turn here. And this is the one that went straight at the keeper, but as you say.
Well, there's a couple of times I just feel that they've backed off Northampton, the back line, when really they've got to come towards the ball. So risky strategy to take.
Atto Ampau, the number six for Whitgift, is their leading goal scorer in the competition with 7 goals. And joint leading goal scorer for Northampton with Logan Briggs, number 9. And Harley Mills, the captain, number 8, both scored 7 apiece.
Good defensive work there from Andre Gray and Jake Grant. Whitgift, good tackle, solid.
What a ball from Gray, and the flag's gone up. Not so sure about that.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about that. What a ball from Gray. I thought he was a holding midfield player, but playing like that with a pass like that,
that's pretty good, yeah.
Bit of the playmaker, deep lying.
Yeah.
Lovely ball.
Well, I think I thought there was a central defender that was playing them on, but Ransom was very sharp. That's going to be a corner. Well, referee says no. Linesman says corner. Referee says goal kick.
Oh, I thought Boniface got back really well there and poked it away for a corner. And I think it's.
Yeah, I think it was a corner.
Bruce from Northampton, who can't quite believe that.
It's one of those. Say to the referee, look, you've got Linesman. Please use him.
It's unusual for Roccia to be coming back into the middle to be taking the kick.
Yes, they're switching around a little bit, aren't they? Sort of rotating positions. So, yeah, you're right. Grant's gone back to right back and Boccia's gone back to the centre.
Yeah, that's not the time to switch. They were just looking to switch when it was coming down the left-hand side. And just got to watch that.
Maybe leave that again. For a little time. Lovely ball in. Corner. And another corner.
Yeah, Brooke Myers just drifting out to this left-hand side for Whitgift. Gets the ball across. Deflected out.
Bench for Northampton School for Boys. Whitgift with the corner. 4 in the box. Grant's got a free header at the back post. And just couldn't get the height there.
Yeah, couldn't get up. Get above the ball. Nicely flighted ball, but just over. Grant's head.
Looking at the results for Whitgift, getting through to here in round 1. They beat Winston Churchill Sports College by 8 2-2 in the first round. Second round, it was another big away win against Kennett School, 9-0. We'll just stop a second here because Whitgift pushing forward. There's a shot from distance, and is that a save? It is. That's a cracking save, and he's pleased about that. Owen Hay. Let's watch this one again.
Sure, he's got a fingertips to see it here. Again, they back off, don't get tight enough to him. That's a great save.
And Brooke Myers there.
Creep in that far corner. What a save that is.
Yeah, definitely.
Down low to his right.
Kept his team in it. Oh, if corner's gone through, surely. It is a goal. It's given. And Whitgift score. Take the lead. And yeah, aren't they pumped up for this?
Asher Agbenon. I mean, keeper does brilliantly. Owen Haig on the first one. Point blank save. But the follow up straight away from Agbenon. He gets the second bite of the cherry and accepts it greatly. Grant comes in at the far post. Gets his body in it. Ricochets into the middle of the box. Agbenon. No trouble with a second attempt at that. Frustration written all over the face of Owen Haig. The goalkeeper did well on that point-blank save, didn't he? First time.
And he just made the great save just a few seconds earlier as well. But interesting, you know, I'm sure you noted that, John, from a corner. He's not a single Northampton School for Boys player actually attacked the ball. Right. Everybody left it for everybody else. And, the cardinal sin there, really, that the ball just swung into the six-yard box and not a single defender attacking it.
Yeah, you've got to go and meet the ball, whether it's a goal kick, whether it's a corner, free kicks. You've got to have players in the position and going and attacking the ball. And
here it is again.
Here we'll see it again. Static, standing. You know, I mentioned that they were too happy to just stand their ground when Whitgift were coming forward with the ball into their half, dropping off. Again, Andre Gray, too much space and time in that midfield area. I think it's just a sort of system that's not helping Northampton at the moment. Oh,
it's gone in.
Well, I think that's Conrad Norman. And it's just come off his back. Just the reaction, wasn't it? The ball got cut across. Didn't know too much about it, but I think if we see the replay, maybe we should give him a little bit more credit than he's due.
Was this deliberate? This is the incredible thing. Did he deliberately do this? If so, this is an absolutely amazing goal. Because it's coming across to him at pace.
I think he knows exactly what he's doing. I think it's at his chest height. I think the only thing he can do is sort of push his chest to the ball. I think I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt and say that's a great goal.
Yeah, it was an absolutely ingenious goal. There's nothing he could do with it. The ball was coming up. And instant thinking was, well, let's just chest it in. And I think that's the first chested goal I've ever seen in a PlayStation Schools Cup final. And almost a third here. And Whitgift really are absolutely romping at the moment. They're getting down both wings. They're pulling Northampton out. And well, Northampton's starting to look a little bit lost out there. They're obviously an attacking team. Here's Kelly. And Grant, who's gone back to the middle, will cover that up and wins the throw.
Yeah, that's great.
Let's have another look at this.
Well, here he is. He kicks the ball out wide. Is that Agbenoni? Out in the
Agbenoni,
wide.
Agbenoni, yep.
Takes on the players. Does really well.
That's a deliberate move, isn't
it? You know, I think that's a deliberate move. I think that's the only thing he knows he can do. But to have the presence of mind to actually chest it towards the goal,
yeah,
that shows me the sign of a real natural instinct.
That's fantastic. Well,
yeah, Ampower just offside, almost level. We've seen him on a couple of occasions this first half, just drifting onto that close call. The official over that far side in, no doubt.
Well, when I'm down there at the end of the match, I might just ask him if he meant that.
It's just, it seems in the middle of midfield, this is where Northampton almost look like they're a player short. And
yeah.
I think it's the sort of diamond formation that Whitgift are playing. Just allows them to have the four in there.
Yeah.
And it's as if Northampton are overwhelmed with the three up front or the two wide players not dropping in with the two in midfield. And
well, we have a lovely view from up here, and it's almost like they're playing a sort of, almost at times, it's a 5-0-3. There's like almost nobody in that central spot. The two midfielders seem to be more defensively minded. And looking, you can see the shape now. You know, they've both sort of gone back.
Well, they need to have somebody standing on Andre Gray.
Yeah.
And they need to occupy that space. That's not going to come from Logan Briggs, the centre forward. It's got to come from midfield.
Yeah.
And they're too deep. And that's, again, the back line, the back three of Northampton have got to squeeze up and push up and make it easy for the midfield to be in connection with the game.
Yeah. And Andre Gray is really having a time of his life out there at the moment because he's got so much space. Here's Agbenoni again going down wide. Turns inside, lovely flick inside. This time, Norman wasn't in the line of fire. Shot from distance. And
he's had a few, hasn't he, Brooke Myers?
Yeah.
I think that's probably his third shot this first half.
Well, I was... Sorry, John, I was just listening, looking at the scores here, so I'll just carry on there. So they had a 9-0 second round win over Kennett School away, a 10-1 home victory over Hove Park School. So 8, 9 and 10 goals in the first three rounds is pretty good going. In the fourth round, the quarter final, a 2-1 away victory against Ivy Bridge Community College, a 424-mile journey. That was for an 11-year-old kid, it's a long way to go for a football match. But they managed to win. Ampar getting both goals there. And in the semi-final, we had a victory against Harefield Academy by 7-4. High school. We had a 9-7 yesterday. Well, 7-4 this time. It seems almost normal. And well, that was one thing for sure. That Whitgift do score a lot of goals. And it was only the quarter-final that Ivy Bridge actually pushed them hard. Here's Ampar again. He's the leading scorer for Whitgift. Hasn't got on the score sheet so far today, but he's so dangerous down that left-hand side.
Well, and as effective as he is, Agbenoni is as effective on the right-hand side. I think these two players, very, very good. You know, the balance with Brooke Myers in the middle of midfield, the sort of number 10 role he's playing, that advanced position off Conrad Norman, and what with Andre Gray just sitting, but getting forward when he can. He's got lovely poise and balance of when to defend, when to attack. It's a pretty impressive system they're playing and set up.
Yeah. Grant again wins the header at the back post. And Gray, again, finding time to turn without under no pressure. And finally, it was Will Barrett who came in with the challenge.
Yeah, Will Barrett's done well. He's really trying to get to grips with that midfield. Will Barrett sticking his job very, very well.
Jake Grant has won just about every corner so far. Norman was thinking about doing a Ronaldo there.
Yep.
Oh, what a goal that was, huh, John?
Well played.
Here's Northampton. Need to try and get a goal. They've got two in the middle here, unmarked. Oh, what a chance that was for Northampton School for Boys.
Oh, it's Kyle Kelly going down that left-hand side. Harley Mills had done really good work, spotted him out on that far side on the left-hand channel. Carl Kelly, you just think, pull it back into that middle of that goal. There he goes again, he's got time to change.
Oh, that's a great Briggs. Ball. Great ball from Briggs. Chance now.
Good covering.
Body-faced as well there.
Yeah, very, very good defending. Exactly what you want your fullback to come across and cover.
Well, good to see Northampton just putting a bit of pressure there. Real big chance early. I think this could be it.
And well, if it's a lovely ball across, isn't it, from Harley Mills out here to
look at this
Kyle Kelly. And then look, two of them.
Two in the middle.
In the middle there. He's got to pull it back away from the goalkeeper.
Yeah, they're queuing up.
Yeah, Harley Mills had gone on, followed his ball in really
Here's
nicely.
Briggs. Oh, that's a great ball into Briggs. This kid's got a bit of talent there. A chance to play a little 1-2. Grant goes over the ball. Briggs has got a chance here. Can he pull the trigger? He's crowded out by Boniface. Boniface again from left back has got involved. He's done the same thing, John, again. He's seen trouble and he's coming from full back to cover.
Yeah, it's brilliant defensive work.
Just didn't fall for Briggs there, did it? He had a half chance. He was looking to pull the trigger and the ball just wasn't there to be hit.
No. It is difficult in this stadium. They're on the biggest of stages, test the character of these youngsters to the maximum. You know, the preparation, the way they're coming out for the start of the game. The PA announcer, sometimes they sort of just get a little bit of a distraction from the noise, from the crowd, from the announcer. interesting to see yes. whether he felt that he might have been offside or what happened.
We've got an unusual. Oh, we'll just watch this again. Oh, oh, what skills!
Oh,
absolutely brilliant. John Scales is applauding next to me, and rightly so. What a goal that is for Whitgift. And it's Brooke Myers who shows skills left and right foot. Even the goalie's come up to give him a hug. He deserves it. What a goal, and Whitgift lead 3-0.
Well, Brooke Myers, take a bow. Here we go. Let's watch and enjoy. Look at that great feat. Composure, skill, both feet, balance. I mean, that showed everything. Excellent, excellent work.
I think we've just seen a... Oh, here's a chance of... Here's Briggs. Briggs is through. And keeper does well. Big object at the near post. I think we've just seen a contender for our goal of the tournament there. Here we go. This is the save that's just happened now.
Well, that's great work, isn't it? Again, from Carl Kelly. He's done really well.
Beautiful ball.
There, just had one touch too many.
Yeah.
Just allowed Sergio Rocha just to sort of put him off. But take nothing away from Alfie Lamb in goal. Stood tall and big.
We talk about that first touch so often, don't we, when we see goals. And there was an example where that first touch just wasn't perfect. And he had to get a second touch in. And by that time, he was closed down. Because Agbenoni, who likes to stretch the legs out on that right wing, plays it in for Myers. Myers is a really busy player and sort of a forward central midfield role. Plays it so well. And Grant just gives a little nudge onto Briggs there, and the free kick's given.
Yeah, you see, I like that. That's good.
That's your sort of style, is it? Yeah, give him a little nudge.
It was. You know, he knew the contact was coming. He knew he needed to be physical. I think a slightly unlucky to concede the free kick. But he certainly sent the signal to Briggs that he's the dominant character. He won't mind too much about conceding the free kick. He's done his job, broke up the play.
That must be an example of what it's like to be a defender at the top when, you know, the crowd are always looking at the positive side of the game. And if a defender goes down, it's, oh, that's good rough play from a forward. He's showing the defender his boss. Do it the other way, it's you dirty sons. Here we go, there's a free kick in. Briggs is coming in. There's a loose ball. Keeper does brilliantly to palm that away. That was a very brave bit of goalkeeping there from Alfie Lamb.
Well, it was interesting because, you know, I just felt that Bruce and Briggs were almost not being picked up. It was like Grant was marking, I think it was Bruce, and it was as if Briggs was free. And it's almost like Owen Hager's got to do, sorry, Alfie Lamb has got to do all the work in goal, and does fantastically well to palm that away.
Yes, that's very brave goalkeeping from Alfie Lambert. Northampton, they might be 3-0 down. I think the scoreline's possibly a little bit unfair to them, but having said that, Whitgift are so hot up front, and their forward line is rampant. But here's an opportunity again, Northampton. Keeper's come out. Yeah, has a little fight with some boots on the ground, but does well again. I do like this goal, dear. But he's just rolled a terrible ball out. Commentator's cursor. I was just praising him for a bit of brave goalkeeping at the player's feet, and just gives a goal away.
Yeah, he's commanding his box.
Yeah,
commanding that area.
Good to see.
Bold and brave, and we spoke about it yesterday, didn't we? The influence that has on defenders around you, it gives them such confidence.
Yeah. And we gave a man of the match to Charlie Bolt yesterday in the final match, and you know, that incredible unit of the defence, how good they were.
Oh, amazing.
But also, the defence is also the goalkeeper, and the fact that they could hold her high line knowing that she was going to come and cover.
Yeah.
Lovely crossfield ball there. That's not the best header in the world from Ruben Hansen. But Northampton clear it. The referee will give a foul for that.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just looking down at Northampton. The manager, Jamie Wilcock. Craig Armstrong, I think that's them. Randy Burns, who's the physio, I think. But the two coaches are down on the side of the pitch.
Yeah.
And they were urging Northampton to squeeze up, to push up the pitch.
Agbenoni. Oh, here's Myers. Myers looks to pull the trigger again and just doesn't come off for him this time.
Yeah, but that's his third effort, fourth effort with his left foot. He struck the goal with his right foot, but he showed he's got, You know, he's two-footed with the way that he went past a couple of defenders.
Yeah.
Just shifted it from his right to his left, back to his right, and finished it off beautifully. But again, he's had that strike on his left.
There's Myers with his right foot, plays it out to Ampol, and offside. It is an unusual situation here that we do have an MC out there. You can hear him on the line, and who's very, very vocal, you could say. He definitely does his job well, and he's giving a running commentary. He's obviously not got a heavy football background, but he's a very excitable man, and sometimes he does occasionally say the wrong thing, you may imagine. And there's no doubt, I'm hearing that a few players have sort of said that they feel he's putting them off. So on that last chance, apparently he was shouting offside.
Was
when so the player felt he was offside and sort of stopped a bit and then realised that he wasn't. So the referee hadn't blown. But so I think there is a responsibility when you're also doing the PA in the arena. You've got to be sort of sometimes respect the players that.
Great run from Gray.
This is Myers with the shot. Oh,
it's the follow up.
Oh, great defence. And well, if Northampton School for Boys get back into this game, they might look back on that piece of defending. Because this was a last gaff's tackle. Comes out to Myers. And, oh, well, that was going in, wasn't it? Keeper was not diving for that. Well, half-time already. What a great first half. That's flown by. And, well, Whitgift, they're high-fiving out there. Not surprisingly, because they are leading by 3-0. And I think, John, they do deserve a lead. You know, maybe 3 is a little bit kind to them, because certainly Northampton have had a few chances. But
definitely, you know, Northampton in the game, I thought they really needed a goal before half-time. They'll certainly need one early in the second half. What I do want to see, though, is some pictures, some selfies from the school, because I'm sure Whitgift, you know, the boys back at the school may well be watching in the hall, or certainly in Northampton. You know, if we can get any selfies in, it'd be great to see the support. Lovely support down below us. From Whitgift again, as you'd expect. And Northampton too. So, yeah, all to play for in the second half. But Whitgift, excellent 30 minutes football.
Well, let's half-time score here. Whitgift School 3, Northampton School for Boys 0. Let's have a quick look at the 3 goals that were scored in that first half. And 15 minutes in.
Yeah, well, it was Magbinoni. They'd had a couple of chances where I think it's Grant gets on at the back post. He missed the earlier header. That one nobody really sort of challenges. They're all a bit static in the box. Grant gets the his body in it. It ricochets down to Magbinoni. He has the first shot. Great work from Owen Haig in goal. But can't do anything about the follow-up. Reels away in delight. Superb goal, and that gets them off. And out of the blocks, 1-0. Second goal, they play the ball wide. Conrad Norman plays it out to Agbinoni, comes back in, and I think that is just a great piece of skill.
Yeah.
The more I see it, the more I think he really knows that's the only thing he can do, Conrad Norman. We'll see it again, good work out wide, comes across, and he does. He just twists his body
absolutely
to get it on target. Goalkeeper, I think, is shocked that he's had the tenacity, the temerity to do that sort of work at the near post. That's brilliant.
For an 11-year-old to have that in his mind, that's a way to score, and that's a feasible way to do it, is incredible.
Yeah. And just give the ball away there, don't they? Now watch this piece of skill here. Brooke Myers, take a bow. Superb. Shifts it from right to left. Northampton will be really disappointed they've given the ball away in such an area. But look at the work he's still got to do. Drags it back, holds off the defender. This bit, 1-2, shifts it. Beautifully weighted, little touch to his right foot. And then curls it into the far corner. Could watch this all day long. What a goal. Beautiful.
Absolutely wonderful goal, and that is certain to make our compilation for our goal of the tournament, which Mr. John Scales will be judging tomorrow at some stage. We just had a PlayStation 4 one in the background. I never got one a few years ago when I nailed it, but apparently
you're still bringing that up, are you?
I'm still annoyed. I had to buy one. My own money.
I remember that day. You've lived off it ever since.
I know. It's on YouTube. Over 1,000 views. They're all me, of course.
Yeah, I was going to say every day since.
I even showed it to one of my cameramen driving down. He couldn't believe it.
Sad.
It was done the proper way, where you absolutely mulled it. And you smack the crossbar rather than all these chippy little things that skillful people do. You know, skillful people, you don't need to do that. You need to hammer it. People are snoring in my ears from the directors. Okay, well, enough of that. Look, we're going to have a quick break for a couple
anyway,
of minutes.
Anyway, I remember it well. It was a stroke of piece of genius.
Yeah, thank you, John.
Right, a lot of work to be done in that Northampton dressing room, isn't there? Let's get them out for the second half and see if they can get an early goal back to make this a great tie. Great game, but a lot of work to do from Northampton.
We'll be back in a couple of minutes.
last 5 minutes of the... Is it 1 minute? So things are really going to turn around quickly. Here he is, number one's coming out for Whitgift, number nine's out now. Let's make some noise for your boys in white and, of course, in fluorescent pink. Nathan, what do you think the advantage of being in highly visible colours for a goalkeeper? And do you think that camouflage might even be even better?
Just
green with white stripes.
Green,
white stripes.
There's too much stripes on a nice, bright green outfield. I think the advantage is it can be quite, it catches your eyes. If you're looking to score a top white Antonina, all of a sudden you see this glorious man in the pink, that might be strategic, you just never know.
You've seen those LED suits that flash and those shoes that flash and stuff.
Potentially that's blinding brightness.
Yeah. But of course you don't want to be tackled by a normal player, and people have got to know you are the goalkeeper.
Exactly.
And you're potentially going to be going in with your hand when someone else is going to be going with their feet. So safety side of things.
So welcome back for the second half of this under 12 elite Schools Cup final. We saw the under 12s yesterday with Wright Robinson having a clean sweep of the A and B teams. Well, Mark Robinson actually lost in the semi final to Northampton 1-0, which is incredible. Wright Robinson have got an incredible attacking prowess and won their final here yesterday 7-0. So Northampton managed a clean sheet. Not managed it here today though. Whitgift have continued to score freely. Whitgift leading 3-0. It would be interesting to see if there has been any amendments made. But Whitgift he's already got a shot in on goal, Myers.
Yeah, that was a lovely little move. Andre Gray into Myers, into Norman, set back. Myers with the shot. Just pulled wide, but such an influence down the middle of the pitch. You talk about the goalkeeper, Grant, the middle of the three at the back. Gray just holding in front of them. Brooke Myers, that spine of this team is just fantastic. And then they got the pace of Agbenoni out wide on the right. Ampau on the left. And the two fullbacks who have covered brilliantly. Rochier and Boniface, really good side. Northampton have got to do something, get themselves back in this game. Got to score relatively early.
Yeah. You know. It's Boniface again.
Oh, good play.
He's been a real thorn in the side of Northampton. So back to the fullback, Rochier. Gray out to Myers. Myers looking to pull the trigger again, but this time crowded out of it. Boniface is marauding down the run. And that left-hand side. Chance here. Here comes. Oh. And hands go to the head for Agbenoni, who's was seeing that in his mind that was going to be a top corner, but it was anything but.
Yeah, it opens up for him, doesn't it? There, he pushes through into the box again. Got to pull it back. How many times have I said that? Yesterday and this morning already. Get to the byline. Really pull it back across the goal, away from the keeper.
Now, but bear in mind, this number three is very attractive because I remember we've given a few man of the matches to left backs actually last year. I remember, and
yeah, we did.
You know, Santo Boniface, he is the defender. He is at the back all the time, and yet whenever there is an attack, he is straight up there. He's a bit like, you know, sort of the Ashley Cole type. You know, as soon as there's a chance, he's off.
Yep.
And he's not caring about the back. He's been told he can go, and he does go. And so he is in the left back. They've only got three at the back, and he's one of those three. But isn't he up there for quite every attack? Big opportunity now for Northampton to
hit by Harley Mills. Good effort, not really hit with enough pace and power. But yes, I mean, the modern game now is your fullbacks have got to be able to do both jobs. They've got to be wing backs, and they've got to be able to defend as well. And if you've got both those attributes to be able to defend as well as attack, whoa, very, very valuable asset to any team.
Yeah.
And Boniface is proving that here this morning.
Next goal is really key here. Northampton must score. You can see that they've got goals in them. They really do have prowess up front. And they've got to score and score fairly quickly. Grant has gone back into the middle. So he has to try and deal with Briggs, and he's doing so well. Here's Agbenoni. Nice inside to Gray. Gray's got a bit of a tension this time. It looks like the coach may have had a few words to say, because that's the first time where Gray's not really had heaps of space to go into. Here's the left back again. I'm really liking his play. Look at him. Oh, this is number six. This is Ampax. And all that ball's gone loose.
I didn't feel there was a danger that was going into the box, into the goal, but I don't think the defender and the goalkeeper felt as confident. Maybe it was the angle that we had. Great work from Ampao.
Yeah.
Ball gets whipped in. Agbenoni. Too much of a danger there. It's always going wide. They were trying to save the corner. Didn't manage it. Agbenoni has taken all these corners, sweeps another one in.
Grant again with a winning the header, going for a goal kick. Well, Northampton School for Boys have only conceded three goals in the whole tournament. Had an 8-0 win over Eatonbury Academy in round one, a 9-1 victory over Horringer Court Middle School. In fact, it's been home matches all the way. Northampton have had home match every round, so that's incredible. Round three was a 6-1 win against Dr. Challoner's Grammar School, and in round four, quarter final, a 4-1 win against Thomas Telford, who've always a strong team. And then in round five, a 1-0 win against Wright Robinson College. So five matches, five home wins, only three goals conceded. So here we are in the final. Whitgift scoring three goals in the first half. And they've scored a lot of goals as well. Not surprisingly, Briggs and Mills both with seven goals apiece. Whitgift finding space in this midfield. Agbenoni wants the ball out wide. Myers decides to turn in. You see a shot from distance. That hurt. Player just goes down there, a little bit winded. Here's Agbenoni. Benoni's got twists and turns. He's never really sure he's a long-legged player. That sort of who was the derby count? Paolo Wanchop, wasn't it? Who was a very similar style. He got long legs. And
yeah.
You never knew which. Sometimes he didn't know which way he was going either. But
no, and as a defender, I played against him. As a defender, it was so difficult to work out Paolo which way he was going to go, how he's going to play. Two number eights kicking the ball against, well, Mills kicking it against Myers to make the referee aware that he hadn't backed off.
Grant again winning the header. He's won a lot of headers in this match.
But ever since
Briggs is hunting down on the edge, just can't get the ball under control. It's out to Kelly. Sorry, John.
Great closing down by Rochier. I mean, ever since they moved Rochier in, he was in the middle, and Grant was out on the right of the three. Ever since they moved Grant back into the middle,
yeah,
I mean, they've looked completely solid. He's been dominant in the middle there. Excellent game.
Myers back to
that's offside.
Agbenoni, and yep, a couple of players offside there. The frustration. Briggs looking to get on the end of this. He's gone out wide for this one. He's not usually been hanging in the middle.
They're just getting a bit frustrated, aren't they, now, Northampton? They know that they have so little time on the ball. Huge credit to Whitgift. The way they hunt the ball down when Northampton are in possession. They just don't have any time to dwell, to get their composure.
Looks like we have a substitute coming on for Northampton, number 14, Connor Budd. Josiah McWilliams-West is coming on. And And number 11 is off, so Cyrus Bruce just takes a little breather. Coach is starting to, he's just imploring the substitute just to push up a little bit.
Okay. Yes,
first tackle. Levon Stewart.
Very nice play there by Northampton.
Williams West on the left, but turns inside. Here's Kelly. Harley Mills. Captain for Northampton, number 8.
It's already heading towards 10 minutes of this second half. Northampton are going to struggle if they can't get a goal. Was that handball? It's bobbled up.
Usually does a given, aren't they, when you're controlling a ball like that. There's that. Ball's played into space, but yes, Whitgift are happy that this game just slows down a little bit now. 3-goal lead.
Yeah, you can just see Northampton, I think they're sort of a bit, heads are down a bit despondent. One of them's going to have to grab this game by the scruff of the neck. I feel if they get a goal now, they suddenly get the impetus. Oh, what a goal! Right, as I said, is that the catalyst for Northampton? Logan Briggs with a fantastic shot into the roof of the net. Alfie Lamb can do nothing about it. Just as we were talking about the body language of this Northampton group of players, up he steps. He's got the ability, we know about it. They win back possession. He gets away. First time he's really been able to get the ball out of his feet. Bang! To the roof of the net. 3-1.
What an absolutely superb goal. And if there's a moment where a match may be turned, we could look back on that at some stage later on down the line and say that was the moment, because Logan Briggs, take a bow, you have just produced a real magical moment in this. And now he's got a one-on-one against Grant. Pulls it out wide. Lovely first touch here from Kelly. Still got the ball, Kelly. Oh! Goes wide, there's a whistle in the crowd, which I think certainly put me off a little bit.
Well, Carl Kelly did really well there. And you can see, suddenly Grant is just backing off Logan Briggs a bit. Suddenly he's aware. A little shove there. We wondered whether there was going to be a whistle for the foul. I think it was a fair shoulder barge, the two of them coming together. Kelly doing really, really well.
They've just sparked up a little bit, haven't they?
Well, maybe. It asks the question, 3-1. Doesn't it? Asks the question, and suddenly that little bit of doubt creeps into the minds of the Whitgift school. 3-0 up.
Here's the goal.
Got to be comfortable.
How brilliant is this? What a shot. Hits it early. And then there's a little bit of silly stuff afterwards as him and Grant decide to fight for the ball to get it back to the halfway line. Thankfully, the referee was on it straight away. Some of these kids don't really know etiquette. They're still learning. They're only young. Oh, here's Myers. Myers tries the curled shot, but it's goes wide. Well, there was a big moment there, and Logan Briggs absolutely produced it for his team. And now, can they continue? Can they move on? There's no doubt that Northampton just have a little bit of a spring in their step. Here's Briggs. Oh, and the flag has gone up. And
that's tight.
Oh, I'll tell you what.
Yeah, that was tight.
We've got a great view from up here, and I think if we can manage to do a stop on this.
Well, it's Boniface there.
Here we go. He's onside. If we'd have rewound that back, yeah. I think he's level.
He steps off, then he comes back onside. Boniface, the left back, certainly level with him.
Yeah. With a real intent here from Northampton. And you can see a couple of players just on five to each other. They're G-ing each other up. That's substitution. Joshua McWilliams-West seems to have just added a little bit of energy as well. He's just seen calling out to a couple of his teammates out there, trying to get a bit of energy going. And a loose ball from, and it's West Whitgift's time to start playing a couple of loose balls. Here's Briggs going down the outside. Nice tackle.
It was a crucial tackle, wasn't it? Conrad Norman.
Harley Mills
getting back.
Good play from the captain. Back to Ruben Hansen. Ruben Hansen's tackled. Now Whitgift have a chance on the counter-attack. Conrad Norman. Lovely ball out to the left side and tackled by Hansen, who gave the ball away initially. Getting back for the tackle on Myers.
Yeah, excellent recovery. Well-timed challenge. Atoned for his earlier mistake.
Getting a good tan down there, aren't they? Enjoying it. We're actually in the shade up high in the heavens. Feeling a little bit chilly up here. I'd love to be again in that sunshine, but...
Huge contrast, isn't it, sitting up here?
Yeah.
Ooh.
And flick on at the near put. Andrew Gray making a rare farage into the penalty box there. He's been dominating midfield, but it's interesting. Since Northampton have actually... They have pushed a little bit of more people into that space. Andrew Gay had so much space in the first half, he's not getting it second half. And the substitute going here, number 14 coming on, Connor Budd for Whitgift. Coming off, having done a pretty good shift, so yeah. Not really using the rolling subs, they're sort of treating it as a more traditional game.
Yeah, he's done well.
That was Atto Ampor, I believe, coming off there. There's a shot from distance. Good save. Owen Haig down sharply to his left. Important
save,
moment.
It?
Yep. See the replay here. Lovely little chip ball. And well, it's Andre Gray who releases the left foot shot, and the keeper's down sharp. Those are awkward ones.
Yeah, very awkward.
Quite close to him as well.
Gray does really well to get that shot low and hard across the keeper into that far post. Excellent work.
Agbenoni, a real handful. He really does remind me of Paolo Ponchop, where he plays and he uses his big long body and he's sort of turning people and still manages to keep the ball in play somehow.
Yeah.
Corner here for Whitgift. Important that from Northampton's point of view that they don't let Whitgift score again. So what
it is, they're in the game. Yeah.
I was going to say, John, were there times when you came up against certain players and you had an individual plan for that one player, such as
yep.
a one chop who was very unique?
You wouldn't
come up against him every day of the week.
No, always thought about the player all week who I was going to be marking centre forward, where it was somebody like Ian Wright. You know, one thing, Bergkamp or Zola, something very, very different. Oh, that's whistle past the far post. Oh, it's Brooke Myers.
What a chance.
Head in his hands. What a chance. The ball retrieved very quickly. And again.
Great as well here.
That influence. The ball fed out by Agbenoni. A little bit too free. Takes his time. Lets it roll across his body. Hits it low and hard as he's got to across the goal. Perfect execution, but just inches wide.
Yeah, that's a superb attempt for it not to be a goal. It was he did the right thing, side foot, trying to put it into the corner. And Whitgift just starting to step up again. Here's Gray again. He'll have a shot from distance, and well over.
So yes, I'd always have a different game plan for every different and so many different styles of play, and you know whether it was as a unit we had to really. Managed that very, very well, or whether it was a personal individual battle that I specifically was going to have a tough afternoon against one opponent.
Yeah.
You've still got to work within the back four as a unit, but yeah, different considerations, you know, every game.
Yeah, and obviously a lot of difference between somebody like a Gianfranco Zola, who's what, 4'11" or something ridiculously short, and
well,
a Paolo Wanchop.
Absolutely. And that's what I mean, it's the positions that. So we see another amazing run.
Yeah. Here's Gray again. He's getting a few opportunities, is Andre Gray. Back out to...
Watch her
force back. Well, fascinating to hear your views, John, as to how you handled these top Premiership players. And well, top world players. You know, Zola was one of the first crew of international world stars that came over. And it was, you know, he was starting to... At your time was when... You know, some of these players were coming over, and now, of course, the Premier League is what it is.
It's dominated now by foreign talent. Then, you know, each team was starting to get that really key influence. influential player. Bergkamp for Arsenal was phenomenal, but just the positions and Cantona at United, it was very different in that early stages. We'd been very used to sort of marking a centre forward, and suddenly they came in and took in that space, the number 10 role, the space between the midfield and the defence, and Arsenal posed so many different questions, and we had to adapt and learn a different sort of level of the game.
Yeah, quickly. Fascinating to hear that. Whitgift again, winning the ball in midfield. There's, you just feel that the game is Northampton have had a little bit of a purple patch. They scored the goal. But that midfield of Whitgift yet again. Just starting to.
Well, what did they get that goal about nearly 10 minutes ago, I guess, didn't they?
Here's Briggs.
Really wanted to add to it. Briggs and Grant.
Oh, good play from Briggs. Managed to beat his man, and that's no mean feat. Grant is a classy player.
Well, Connor Budd, substitute on, did really, really well to get across and cover. Again, that's what I like about this team. Jake Grant went in for the challenge, but Connor Budd didn't expect him to win it. He presumed he would lose it, and that's always one of the great lessons for defenders. Presume the worst.
Yeah.
And he covered over brilliantly.
Boniface has moved up into midfield now. He was virtually playing that beforehand anyway. he's officially been given a bit more rein to push up on the left side. Here's Gray. Gray gets one touch onto the left. What a block that is. And that's a goal-saving block there from Levon Stewart. The number three. Whitgift again, so close.
Well, he's been everywhere, this lad. Lovely ball in.
Crosses
it. As has Gray.
Yeah.
As I said, you know, he's just moves really effortlessly.
Yeah.
From a deep line position into an attacking position. Always seems to be in the right place at the right time. That's a great skill to have. But you're right, Boniface, the left back, who we've raved about for nearly 50 minutes of the game. He's gone into that left hand side to replace Ampau. He's done well, hasn't he? The fullback, come on, Connor Budd. Referee didn't like the challenge.
A little pull of the shirt from Briggs on Budd there.
Well, it was unlucky because he was nearly away, wasn't he?
Yeah. Blue free kick. Yeah, Briggs looks a real handful. Every time the ball comes to him, he's looking to make something happen. You see why he scored so many goals in this tournament. Northampton crew are out there just contemplating what can they do. 10 minutes to go. Two goals behind. Boniface. Probably the first loose pass he's played all match, that was. Whitgift get the throw. Well, we are going to be coming to that first moment of the first match, John. Of,
do you know, I was just thinking. I was just thinking about that then, and I know you and I are going to have a difference of opinion. And you're going to give me that look when I announce who I'm choosing and say. Maybe I would have given it to somebody else. I've just got a feeling that. Anyway.
My opinion doesn't count. You know, there's sort of the Sunday Pub League standard against Premiership in England. I think I'll bow to you, John.
Couldn't quite get at the end of that one. Little shot of the Whitgift bench there. We saw Steve Kember on the far end of the bench.
First attempted skills from Stewart wasn't really going anywhere, and it's nice to do that move when it's appropriate, but in that situation actually that wasn't the time to do it. And now, oh, here's a counter attack. Here's Myers looking inside.
Cut it back, well done.
Norman wants it, and over the bar from Norman. Well, he put in a goal, which is definitely one of the most unusual goals we'll have seen. And here's this one. Here's a counter attack again. Northampton have already kicked the ball. They're trying to speed the game up here, but nothing happening at the moment in real time.
This is bright play, you know. That's what I'm talking about. The intelligence to pick out a player, pulling the ball back away from the goalkeeper in those wide areas. Gave Norman the chance to have the shot.
Yeah. Five games today. This is game number one. And coming up next is the Under 14 Elite Schools Cup. Whitgift again up against KPS School. Here's a chance. Oh, what a save! And what a run and a double save! Well, Alfie Lamb, Owen Haig in the goal. For Northampton, has just kept his team in this. What a run this is.
Again, it opens up for him. It's the shape at time. They just sat back a bit, Northampton. Haven't been far away, have they, at all? But just come up against a better team on the day. It's a really, really good outfit, this Northampton side. I think that just shows the quality that is in this Whitgift team. And some days you've just got to hold your hands up and say you've been beaten by a better team. There's still time, of course. If they can get a second goal, things could be different now.
Yeah.
Get on the ball early. Are Whitgift going to switch off a little bit? Give them an opening. Give them that glimmer of hope that with 7-8 minutes to go, there is plenty of time.
Harley Mills has lined this one up and it looks like he's going to have a shot here from long range.
That's better.
With the left foot. Had some interest, but now here's a chance of Whitgift, and they're 2-on-1 here. Northampton score for Morris, trying to get back, but here's Norman, and Norman has scored. The classic counter-attack. Northampton had committed players up front, and Conrad Norman scores his second goal of the match, and it's number 4 for Whitgift, and their trophy is sealed.
Wow. Lovely release of the ball from the substitute, Connor Budd, great weight. Here he is, look at that for a pass. And this is all about taking it quickly. Look, catches Owen Haig completely off guard, didn't realise he was going to hit the ball quite so quickly. And a lovely deft touch from Conrad Norman, running onto a wonderful pass from Brooke Myers. 4-1. And really, I think that puts the seal on this victory for Whitgift. We were just talking with that free kick just seconds before that they needed to get that second goal.
Well, I had a few substitutions there. We saw Ashley Agbenoni going off. For Whitgift, George Mace and Noah and Antoniades have scored, and there's a goal for Andre Gray. Well, he's been trying all match. He's got one to his name. It's goal number 5 for Whitgift. And Andre Gray has been threatening all game. Finally gets his name on the score sheet.
Well, this is making my man of the match job very, very difficult, I have to say. Boniface, lovely weighted ball in. There he is.
Great touch.
Andre Gray has been superb in this game. Not easy.
There's a few players there coming off. There's a Boccio there is off. Conrad Norman, score of 2 goals, is off. The goalkeeper is off. We've seen the goalie Owen Haig is off for Northampton. And Ollie Dale is on. Also seen. Well, everybody's coming on and off. I've seen a number 15 out there. We don't even have a number 15 on our list, but it could be 13 that doesn't like the unlucky number, which is Ben Lyons. And Pascal Rocher is on. Could be brother of Sergio Rocher. So, John, I think we are at that stage. We've only 4 minutes to go. I think it's time we asked you, John.
Well, I've got to say, this has been the hardest decision I think I've had. I think Grant's done brilliantly at the back. Goalkeeper's done very, very well. The two in midfield for me, Andre Gray and Brooke Myers, either of those two could have had it. They've been absolutely excellent, but that man there, he takes my pick. Somto Boniface, fantastic work. At left back, he's moved into the left side of midfield. I just love the way that he's moved around the pitch. I love the touch he's had, the vision, the awareness, the energy he's shown. But as I say, it's really a reflection of a fantastic team performance from Whitgift. And credit to them that it could have been really any one of the 9 core players out there. I mean, look, Connor Budd on the ball now. He's been excellent since he's come on. This man has been a colossus. Before in midfield, lovely set back, and there he is, Boniface on his probably weaker right foot. Brooke Myers got a bright future. Really has excellent play. So those Whitgift boys back at school. There's the coaching staff of Whitgift, delighted at the moment, navigating the final couple of minutes of this game. Comfortable victory, well deserved. And Northampton shouldn't be too disappointed. They've come up against a very, very good side and they've showed some really good play throughout here.
Here's Grant, the captain. Plays it out wide left. Pascal Rocha. Boniface. A player of the match who really has been attractive. He's enjoying himself a little bit now. He's roaming all over the place.
Yeah, he is.
I think he's hoping to try and get on the score sheet here. He's asking for the ball.
He just looks like he is loving his football. And at 5-1, and you're winning a final, and such a prestigious final as this, the Under-12 Elite Schools Cup. All of the players can be. Northampton will be just desperate for the whistle to go. Yeah. Frustrated that they couldn't do more about this. But you've got to give huge credit.
Lovely turn. Northampton managed to hold that one. But the match is, we're into the final stages here of the match. Whitgift looking for a double here, of course. They're up next in the Under-14 Elite, which will be played on the full-size pitch.
Carl Kelly just getting caught by Andre Gray there.
Yeah.
Free kick.
They've obviously arranged the finals here. It's lovely that they've sort of, you know, when teams have had the full-time whistle, when schools have had two teams in, they've put consecutive finals in.
Yep.
It was Wright Robinson's day yesterday. Whitgift have taken the first of their two finals with a comprehensive victory here in the Under-12 Elite Schools Cup Final. A 5-1 victory against Northampton School for Boys. I'm really enjoying seeing these two teams. You know, they're all shaking hands, they're all very positive. It's very young, it's not the end of the world. You've got a lot of football ahead of your kids.
Absolutely, that's the one lesson they've got to take from this, is it's an amazing experience, but there's a long, long way to go in their football careers. Don't be, you know, be disappointed and annoyed in the moment, but pick your heads up. What a season these Northampton boys have had. It's a moment of crowning glory for this Whitgift school. And
Mr. Boniface is getting hugged by everybody.
Well, they want to use his PlayStation 4, don't they?
They're all going to be around his house every week during the winter, aren't they?
I know you got another match. He's obviously very popular in the team, even more popular now.
His parents are currently shaking their heads, going, "Oh no!"
Yeah, what have they done up there?
Yeah, because it's a team. It's a team prize, of course. You've got to invite all your teammates over to play.
It's a great performance from Whitgift. Great job from Steve Kember and the coaching staff down there.
Well, let's have we'll just see there's Jake Grant, and we're just going to have a quick look through the goals. The final score here, Whitgift 5-1, possibly you would say actually the scoreline does reflect the state of play, and it was Northampton didn't really have many chances. They did look threatening. You could see why they've scored lots of goals. You can see why they got to the final. But ultimately, Whitgift dominated in midfield and had far more chances. And John, here are the goals.
Yeah, this is Grant getting in the far post. Has the first effort, Agbinoni, and then gets the second bite of the cherry. Makes no mistake after Owen Haig did good work in the goal. Comes back to him. He's the quickest to react. There are bodies in there. Just Northampton, at times, their own worst enemies, not being able to clear the lines, quite challenge as robustly as they would have liked to have done. Reels away in delight. Second goal, Conrad Norman, striker, feeds it out wide. Agbinoni, great work, pulls it back, and oh, could that be one of the goals of the tournament? Is that a moment of magic from Conrad Norman? I think so. Knows that his only option with this ball when it comes in is to chest it goal bound. No, and he can't keep that one out. Absolutely delighted with his contribution to that first half at the near post. Calling for the ball. Oh, it's brilliant. Brilliant. And that was really a case of the next goal was going to be so important. Northampton frustrated, they give the ball away. Brooke Myers really was possible contender for man of the match for me. He may well end up getting goal of the tournament. This is certainly a contender. Rolls the number eight, gets away from him, gets past two players inside, rolls the ball from right to left, and then just watch this touch here. Just sets it up onto his right foot perfectly. Went past the players with ease, and that was 3-0. And was there a way back for Northampton? We said they've got to find something in that second half. Almost on the stroke of 40 minutes, that man, Logan Briggs, the real threat up front, burst through three players around him, but makes no mistake, shows us really what he was about, because we knew he had that potential. We knew he had something in him. The ball gets one back well. Still got a lot of work to do. It was the first time you really felt that Grant wasn't tight and close on him. Give him half a yard, and that's what he's capable of. 3-1. You felt there was a chance for them to get back into this goal, into this game. But no. Conrad Norman with his second, making it 4-1. Good work from the substitute there. Connor Budd releases Brooke Myers. Lovely weighted ball. He just held his run in the middle, didn't go offside, and took the ball really early. Lovely instinctive finish. Pass the despairing Owen Haig now. Concedes his fourth goal. The frustration from his perspective. He had a decent game. He couldn't do anything about that. Could he? Right in the corner. That made it 4-1, and then it was just a case of sort of seeing out the game. 5 minutes to go there. Just a little bit sloppy in defence. Whitgift enjoying their football now, aren't they? Boniface, man of the match. Lovely ball into the path of Andre Gray. Superb performance from him in midfield. Strikes it brilliantly with his left foot. Fantastic performance from Whitgift. 5-1.
Well, we're going to just go down. We're going to take the presentations. Got a few words from the winning coach, and we'll be back shortly for the next match in the under 14 final.
Mr. Boniface, where is he? Come on down. Man of the match. Very well done. There are some very, very, very happy ladies in the audience, I can assure you. They've got their iPads in the ready and they're taking all the snaps. Very well deserved. Mom's just hoping there's two remote controls in there, and I think there is, so they can both play against each other. And that's all part of the fun with PlayStation. Play together, it's amazing. One last time for your man off the match! Are we moving on now? We're going to be giving up for our runners-up. They played so very, very well. You should be extremely proud of them. It's Northampton School for Boys! So once again, our next GMBSFA awarding the runner-up team to number one, Alfie Lang, number one, Owen Haig, number two, Ruben Hasten, number three, Levin Stewart, number four, Will Barrett, number five, Will Cowley, number six, Kyle Kelly, number seven, Isaac Black, number eight, Haley Mills, number nine, Logan Briggs. Playing in 10, Ted Dolby. Playing in 11, Cyrus Bruce. In 12, Adam Alexander. In 13, Ollie Dale. And 14, Josiah McWilliams-West. Congratulations to everyone at Northampton School for Boys. Runners up in the PlayStation Schools Cup final for under 12 elite schools. And now,
to celebrate the winning team. You know them, the boys in white, ladies and gentlemen, get ready to celebrate for Whitgift! As they come up to take their very, very deserving championship medals. Take it away, guys, incredible stuff from Whitgift School. They played extremely well here today. 5 goals, what a performance from the boys in white.
So a round of applause for player number one, goalkeeper Alfie Lamb. Number two, Sergio Rocha. Number three, Sumpto Boniface, the man of the match. Number four, Andre Gray. Number six, Anto Ampor. Player in seven, Asha Abiwan. In eight, Brooke Mayers. In nine, Conrad Norman. Playing in 10, George Mace. In 11, Pascal Rocha. In 12, Noah Antiones. In 13, Ben Lyons. Playing in 14, Connor Budd. And your captain of Whitgift School. In number five, Mr. Jake Grant. Congratulations to everyone from Whitgift School, champions of the 2018 PlayStation Schools Cup Final.
Get your Sony Xperia ready, at the guys. Get those flashes on. Because it's about to be celebration time.
Once again, put your hands together for the 2018 PlayStation Schools Cup Champions!
Thank you.
So Steve Kember is with me from Whitgift. First of all, before we start, John Scales is up there doing the commentary. There's John waving at you. Just said pass on his best and a congratulations. Your boys did very well here today. You must be so proud.
Yeah, obviously we knew it was going to be a difficult game, but you know the football the boys played today was exceptional at times. And you know, it's congratulations to Andy Martin for all the time he spent coaching the boys over the last 6 months. But to be fair, Northampton were a good side. You know, they had two or three really good players, and I think we did well to actually nullify them, and then obviously scored the goals to put the game to bed.
John was really unsure about the man of the match. There were so many good players on the pitch. In the end, he gave it to the left back, who very rarely, you know, we likened him to Ashley Cole at one stage, the way that as soon as you got the ball, he was off. And you would know that, of course. You know, you do have some real talent in that team, don't you, for this year?
Yeah, obviously, I mean, you know, this is the elite competition, and obviously we've got boys from different academies, and, you know, they're taught to get hold of the ball, play football, run with it. Sometimes they run with it too much and their decision-making is poor, but, yeah, lots of talented players on both sides.
Yeah. They're 11 years old. You've got quite a few years with them to come at Whitgift. A lot of tears, a lot of happiness. You must be looking forward to it because, you know, they've won the first major competition. They're so young, they've got so much to come.
Yeah, obviously, I'm getting a bit old now, mind you, so whether I'm still be there in about 4 or 5 years is another thing. But, yeah, no, it's a good bunch of lads, and, you know, we've got another side coming to play at 11:30, yeah. The under-14s. You know, that's the elite competition as well, and there's some good players as well, so hopefully we'll see some good football in that game as well.
I've been at Twickenham a fair few times. Whitgift is usually a rugby school, so you're actually turning it over a little bit here in some football finals. From a Whitgift point of view, it's great to see football being represented here.
Yeah, I've actually been to those finals myself, and yeah, I think Colin Pates takes a lot of credit for that. He was brought into the school about 23 years ago, and it's risen from there really, because it was just social stuff on a Wednesday afternoon. But now, you know, we're in national competitions, and yeah, you're quite right. You know, we're well pleased with the way things have gone. Yeah.
Steve, thank you for your time and congratulations.